To crochet this motif, we will start from here where the arrow, red arrow, and we will start with crocheting over the pecking cord. It's indicating on the diagram that we have to crochet 15 single crochet stitches. So I already have prepared amount of stitches that I need to crochet. You will have to take your time and make 15 single crochet stitches over the pecking cord. And this is where we are on the diagram, right in here. So after we made 15 stitches over the pecking cord, we'll have to drop the pecking cord and crochet one direction. We'll turn our work 10 single crochet stitches, and then turn work again and crochet over this second row, the third row of 9 single crochet stitches. Both rows and throughout all motif, all stitches are made into the back loop. So after 15 stitches, drop your pecking cord, turn your work, and crochet only single crochet stitches. Pecking cord is right here, you don't have to worry about it. Make 10 single crochet stitches. We crochet into the back loops. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight, nine, and 10. After this, again turn your work and crochet back 9 single crochet stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. After that, when you look at the diagram, you will see the sign right in here. This is where we're at. We finished 9 single crochet stitches. Now we will pick up pecking cord and crochet over the pecking cord 1 single crochet stitch right here. Make sure it's tight. Then we're turning our work and crochet over the last row and over the pecking cord 10 single crochet stitches. So now I turned my work and into the edge of the leaf we crochet 10 single crochet stitches. Three, four, five. Let's stop here and adjust our pecking cord. For the pecking cord, you have to take thread that is around 20 inches long and times 4. So 20 times 4, it will be 80 inches. And you fold it, you take two of them. Fold it in half and again in half to have 4 strands of pecking cord. Continue crochet 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And again, adjust stitches. This short tail you can cut. After you pull on it, you don't really need this short tail anymore. So we will cut short tail of working thread. And when you look at the diagram, you have 10 single crochet stitches and then 2 single crochet stitches over the pecking cord and into the 2 stitches of the first row. Make sure that this stitch will be tight, the first especially. So we have to crochet over the pecking cord and into these 2 stitches here of the first row. Here it is, this little tail. So find the back loop, first stitch, try to make it tight, it's very important, and one more stitch into the back loop. After that, according to the diagram, we have the stitches right in here. It says 7 stitches, and we crochet them. You see these dots? That means that you have to connect those two parts. So you connect each stitch you crochet over the pecking cord and over the 7 stitches of the last row of the first leaf section. So we turn in our work and crochet 7 single crochet stitches over the pecking cord and into the back loops of the leaf. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Adjust the pecking cord. And after that, 7 single crochet stitches made. Now we will crochet 10 more single crochet stitches only over the pecking cord. And the rest of this work we will crochet exactly the same way as we did this stitch. So we will crochet 10 single crochet stitches, drop the pecking cord, crochet back 10 stitches, then turn work and again crochet back 9 single crochet stitches. Pick up your pecking cord, crochet 1 single crochet stitch over the pecking cord, turn your work and crochet over the pecking cord and over the last row into the back loops 10 single crochet stitches. After the 10 single crochet stitches, we have 3 single crochet stitches made into the stitches over the row right over here. Make sure those stitches are tight. So this leaf, I'm not going to crochet with you. It's done exactly the same way as the first one. All the rest of the leaves and sections of this diagram, of those little sections, there are 5, 6 of them. You have the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All of them are made exactly the same way. So all you need to do, just remember to watch for those stitches, which stitches goes where, what are they, and how to read the diagram. So now I will stop right in here. You will have to crochet 1, 2, and 3 leaves. I will take my prepared piece to continue and show you how to do this work. So I have already my 3 leaves of the first part of leaf. I have 1, 2, and 3 Here they are. And I will turn it, of course, you will be going this way. Now let's look at the diagram. Right in here, you can see, after you finish the 13 stitches of the leaf, 13 stitches, you have 6 more stitches that need to be crocheted into this long row, 6 single crochet stitches into here over the pecking cord with those stitches. So here I am at this place, in this spot. So we will crochet 6 single crochet stitches over this first row of the third section. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Sometimes I need to hit the front loop in order to find the back. So adjust the pecking cord. And then we will crochet. 6 single crochet stitches are done. Next, our step is 3 single crochet stitches into the stitches over here that unfinished. We have unfinished area of the second section of the leaf and unfinished few stitches of the first row. So now we creating a stem. We create a long stem, and at first we have to connect this part of a stem to the leaves, this part of the stem to the second leaf, and 2 more stitches to the 2 stitches of the first leaf. And then only over the pecking cord we will crochet 15 single crochet stitches for the stem. So first we have, after 6 stitches, we have 3 stitches that connect to the second part and 2 single crochet stitches that are connected to the first. So let's make this one. So we have 3 stitches into the back loop. Two more right here into the very first little tail. Here is left for us to deal with 2 more stitches. Make sure those stitches are nice and tight. I needed to make it tighter. And 2. Somehow I see I have a third stitch, so I will have to finish that. Probably I made 1 more stitches, so I will have to take this to consideration and make 1 more. And adjust the pecking cord, of course. That your work look neat and all your stitches nice and uniform, and you don't see your pecking cord through. Now there's 1 more point in the diagram. Right in here we have slip stitch. Here it is. The slip stitch is, you have to connect right now after this last 2 stitches, connect to the very first little bump that is very visible to you. The first stitch, you will see that bump, right? I will try to zoom that you could see mine. right in here, this stitch right in here. This is where I will make a slip stitch. You can make slip stitch or single crochet. Actually, I will make single crochet stitch so that everything will look neat and nice. The reason we're doing this connect to that very bump is that when you finish your work here, this sleeve, that it will not kind of detached and stick out, that it will look nice and even transition from stem to leaf. You see how it looks like. It's like it started from here somewhere. So it is very important to connect here, that it will look nice and neat, your work. So I will make it over the backing cord, single crochet stitch right here, and I lost stitch. That's not good. Okay, coming back to that. Let's do it one more time. Here we are. So we have our first stitch of those 15. So I made one and 15 more stitches over the backing cord only. Let's do that. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now make sure that all your stitches are tight. Pull everything that you will not see anything. And if you look at diagram, you could see we're turning our work and again over the backing cord and into the stem, into this row of the 15 stitches. We crochet stitches, of course 15 here, but totally will be 30 stitches. You crochet all the way to this place. So all you need to do, you will actually connect, stem is connected with this new leaf that we will start after, 30 stitches all the way to this place. So turn your work and over the backing cord, into the back loops, crochet 30 stitches. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Stop and adjust my backing cord right here so that this area will look nice and neat. So continue crochet over this edge, 20 more stitches. You will stop in here and you will crochet again. I can turn this for you upside down. That will be easier probably. I would actually recommend to turn your diagram. That will be more convenient and understandable where you at this moment, at what place. So we are right in here. Actually, if you finish, you will be right in here. You will then after this point, after 30 stitches, you will crochet 7 stitches over the backing cord only, and then the last two leaves you will make exactly the same way as those three. And each stitch, each section, the fifth and the sixth, after you will, when you will finish, on the way to finish the edge of each leaf, you will go and crochet extra stitches into the stem. You can see that right here we have six stitches, and then you go back, crochet over the pecking cord and over the part of this row, and then only over the pecking cord, and again the same story. And then I will continue for you right in this spot. So I will not continue here. You can do this already without my help, because I think it's all very clear what to do. It's all repetitive, very repetitive pattern, very easy actually, if you know what you're doing. So here I am. I actually will show you what happened, what will happen after you will finish the fifth and sixth section of the leaf. So this is how it will look like. And then the last section for the leaf, the sixth part, there are four stitches left to crochet, and those stitches are made over the pecking cord into the stem. So here we are, we will finish. You will see how to finish this work. So nice and tight, the first stitch. Let's find the stitch right here. One, make sure it's tight. Then the rest stitches will be easy to make tight. Two, three, and four. Now, after you finish this, you can or sew the pecking cord pieces, whatever is left. You want to have pieces left. You can or sew this, or on that side, or on this side, whichever side of the leaf you prefer. I would use both of them. It doesn't matter if right or left. Both look really nice, and both sides can be used in the same in the same outfit, whatever you will make. Here's the other leaf. They look a little bit different, but so what? In the nature, they don't look the same. So we can use one like this and go and change them, one turn another direction. You can or sew it, or the best thing that I start doing just lately, I will take two strands of the pecking cord and weave inside the stem. We have two rows here, and another two pieces you can weave inside those stitches right in here. So just take a right needle and weave everything inside. The same way, make sure to sew tight the last piece, that it will be nice and kind of finished neatly, that it's, the transition will be flowing beautifully, not like sticking out, like right now it's kind of staying out here a little bit. So you will want to sew this thread inside the rows somewhere into the where the pecking cord is, and you will not see the thread. And this is how it will look like, your leaf after the finished work.